As you enjoy getting to know women and they get to know you, like your personality and your kiddos and your favorite shows and what you think about pacifiers and potty training, start heading out into deeper waters by sharing more of the real you. For example, I would say something like, I get a little embarrassed when my daughter has a play date at our house and she won't share any of her toys. And then I just see how they handled that. And if they gave me the, ooh, it stinks to be you kind of a look, or they said nothing, packed up and put me on their prayer chain, then I knew that relationship would need to stay at happy stage. And that's okay. Not all friendships can move to the next level. We do not need to share our hearts with everyone. We can have friends who just know some of us. But if, when I would share my little embarrassment, they would say something like, me too, then over time, I would share more and more of myself. Me too women are the best. They're safe. These are the kinds of people that remind you that you are not alone when you share something vulnerable because they always admit when it's happened to them. Me too, it's a great phrase. And these are the kinds of friends that have become my best friends. They know all of me, the shiny parts and the ugly, messy parts. These are friends I can really trust so I can reveal all myself to them. Did you know that one definition of the word trust is to be careless? I love that. These are the women that I can be careless with. I don't ever have to edit what I say or how I say it. You know, after I finished nursing my third daughter, I had a few pounds to lose, actually more than a few pounds. So I joined a few women in my neighborhood who ran really early in the morning to get some exercise in before their families woke up. I know, it's ridiculous what us moms have to do to fit it all in. Anywho, I wasn't very fast, so I ran at the back of the pack. But that is where I got to know Karen. Karen, as it turned out, was a Me Too person, so we could share all kinds of things with each other. And Karen listened to me morning after morning talk about my anger that I'd never really admitted to anybody before. And I told her about my fears and my resentments. I mean, I just let it all hang out with her. And one of the things that I love about Karen is that she never told me I couldn't or shouldn't feel those things. She never rushed me to happy. And so I never had to buck up or fake it with her. I could just trust her with the real me. And as a result, those yucky things that I brought out into the light with Karen, they've been loved by her, and they are being healed by God.